Okay, so if you ever wonder how many times I fail myself before I get it right, it might be 20, it might be 50 times before I get it right, and I'm a little bit picky when it comes to the things I say on camera. So if I drift off and ramble a lot, I start over and it becomes very difficult to remember all I said. So, you know, keep that in mind if I'm rambling, if I'm, you know, talking about things I shouldn't talk about. It's just, I'm getting sick and tired starting the video over and over and over. So now it's 4.5 weeks out from the show. The show is in Sweden. It's a 2-day show, regional on Saturday and pro qualifier on Sunday. You know, I do have intention to do damage at the show, even though I'm coming back from an injury that's very, very severe. But I need to approach it like I do every time. And the way I approach it is like nothing happened. So I push myself as hard as I can. Of course, you know, when it comes to chest training, I hold back. And, you know, today I pushed 2 plates in the inclined Smith machine, which is good. 14 reps, which is, you know, it is very, very good. But then again, I can compare it to last time. And then right away, I understand why my chest is not, you know, overpowering. It's not hard like it used to. And I understand that I need to train chest a little bit more frequent. So either I'm going to implement a little bit of chest on my shoulder days, or I'm just going to hit it a little bit more, like every 3 days or something like that, just to get it a little bit back, because it's not going to be like it was, but it might be good enough to make my physique look like it did. So we'll see how it goes. 4.5 weeks ain't a lot of time. It's more like 4 weeks to do improvements. And like I said before, the last 3-4 days is just carving up and getting ready for the show. So training, very happy with those 2 plates in the incline, very happy with 40 kilos with the dumbbells. My hand is still shaking, my shoulder is still not tight enough to you know, stabilize all the weights. Even when I did a drop set, I went down to like 15 kilos and it's still shake a little bit. So I understand that it's still a muscle that's need to grow back and fill up and tighten that area. Still have a little bit of issues with my collarbone, and yet again it's just the lack of muscle. Today I was very, very light, so that might have something to do with it. You know, water does help you with stabilizing your joints, just because that muscle pulls water and it pushes against the joint and stabilizes it by, you know, a little bit at least with the water. So 2 kilos lighter than I used to be. All-time low today, 100.3. Very happy with that. Implemented a couple of low days now. My base diet is 240 grams of carbs, about 50 grams of fat. My low days are 160 grams of carbs. And I'm up to like 2 hours of cardio now, training 7 days a week. So I'm pushing as hard as I can, and it will be fun to see how it goes. I've doubted myself, but I know I can make it. And I know if I take every day and just do as best as I can every day for the next 4 weeks, I will be, you know, somewhere happy with the result. And you know, I don't think a lot of people could do imitate what I've just done. So that's that. When it comes to posing and things like that, I need to work a little bit on it. Still haven't found out if I'm gonna do the right side with the side chest and side triceps. I might do the left side, just because I can't see the pop on that side yet. Might be lack of muscle. Might be, you know, nerves or whatever, that still a little bit iffy when it comes to that right side. So we'll see what I do. When it comes to posing, not chest, you know, not showing my little dent in my chest, It's no problem at all. You won't see it at all. The only shot you can see it is like a most muscular, but I don't hit it the same way as I used to, so you won't see it. You can see it if you really, really put an effort to it, but the judges don't know me, so they probably won't see it. So that's that. Like I said, I'm pushing hard now. You know, coaching myself, it is, you know, it's a little bit different. Not only because I can't hashtag my coach on Instagram, but, you know, even though you have this plan and you have set it out and you implemented refeeds, you still like don't want to do it because that's always a voice in the back in your head go like, you shouldn't really be eating this. You shouldn't really be eating this much. And that's always a difficult part of it, but I know what works and I've done this before. I did it last time when I did the regional show in the spring last year. I did have refeeds and they worked very, very well. The only thing that I need to keep in mind, like I told you guys before, the day after a refeed, it's very, very hard. Your blood sugar is kind of all over the place. So that's the most difficult day. After that, it's just pushing through again. And for the next 3-4 days, depending on how long you're gonna have low days, just keeping your head down and push. And you know, you get through it. And it's all about how bad you want it. And I want it quite bad right now. So I'm gonna do this for the next 4 weeks and I'm gonna be somewhat happy, like I said. Other aspects of prep is like TV now, it's just, it's hard to focus. And on top of that, you know, a lot of things that you see on TV is weird to me. You know, been watching a little bit of Disney and it seems like they buy up all the series and just ruin them. You know, you've seen it with Marvel, Star Wars, everything. It's like, and the movies they're making, it's like weird shit is going on. It's always like an interracial couple. It's always obvious gay guy that run around and yelling. Then it's like maybe a transsexual or some non-binary crazy guy. It goes to the point where it's like, really, is that all it's about now? Pushing feelings and pushing agendas on TV, you know. I watch TV for entertainment reasons, and you know, if you want to utter your opinion, I don't think that's very entertaining, especially when it's the same opinion over and over and over, 10 different ways and 10 different series, and you know, movies just the same with different characters. I find it just weird now. So TV is out. And one of the reasons that they're pushing, you know, the things that they push on TV is either to divide us or to make us accept everything. Or the third thing is most likely the thing that's going on. It's a way to distract us for what's really going on in the world, because now things are getting heated. Only thing I watch is YouTube, really. And like I said before, I watch, you know, a dude playing Bloons Tube. What's it called? Bloon Tower Defense. A guy playing with monkeys popping balloons. That's as simplistic as my mind gets at times. So, anyways, tomorrow we're gonna hit back. We're gonna film a little bit. I'm gonna drop that video probably a little bit later. But me and my cameraman is doing back. It's looking better and better by the day, so that's gonna be fun. And you know, we'll see what happens tomorrow. Training a little bit different now than we did the last preps. What's different between this prep and the last prep, and what we can implement and learn from this prep on the contrary from last. Because last prep, I trained very, very heavy, very high intensity. And for those who don't know, intensity is how hard you can get, how hard you can go in a short, very, very, very short period of time. So intensity ain't drop set or superset or whatever you think it is. intensity is maximum effort in maximum or at least amount of time. So one rep max is high intensity. The highest form of intensity is one rep max. So keep that in mind when you're throwing around words that you don't know. People using it, but the definition is different than we using it for. It's same as symmetry when it comes to bodybuilding. Symmetry is left to right, but we use symmetry as, you know, if your calves are the same size as your arm, you have good symmetry. It's nothing to do with symmetry, but we throw it around like we know something, but we don't. So, by the way, it's called harmony if your body is flowing and, you know, you want to use symmetry, use harmony, because that's the right word, in my eyes at least. Anyways, I'm gonna make my chicken, gonna pick up my kids, and I'm gonna make this video. Then I'm gonna remind you to subscribe and like and share and do whatever the F you want. And I'll see you next time. Bye, guys.